That was pretty
Welcome back
good idea.
To Imsh's Dream.
Imsh's Dream.
Here's my sketch of the tower.
Nice. Mm. Okay.
So you got both
Roll
sides
me
and just tips.
A regular attack.
It's the regular
That's somewhere regular on this
damage.
Map.
Oh, damage.
Regular damage.
Like two dice, three dice. Like
yep.
Two in this pile. Okay.
You get three dice.
Still swag. 4, 2, 3.
4, 9.
Okay, so what's total damage?
Well, 18.
Plus
after,
9 is 18.
Or, yeah, after raging frenzies. Yeah, 18.
Okay. You charge forward. You start attacking like crazy. And the flames...
The muscles are glistening.
The flames on Yolswag are... they change from orange to white.
Ooh.
And two hits, cut off both of its legs.
Just a flesh wound.
With your strikes.
Go at me.
And it kind of collapses, and it's more, it gets to the point, it's not quite eye level yet, because melees are fucking enormous.
Yep.
But it's low enough that you can see, like, it's almost eye to eye.
Small. Yeah.
Yeah, you kind of see it, like, neck kind of area is directly forward, but you can, it's pretty close to its head. And
pissed off a
it's going
in the
to
way, guess. Go hunt us down. Go kill us.
It's alright. Okay. So it hits you twice, right? This is dream realm.
Yeah.
So, and it seems like its attacks just don't do anything to you. Roll me three more attacks.
Come on, baby. Come on, baby.
Yep.
Reckless attack again. But yeah, 19 or 20. So, not, or 29 or 20.
Mm-hmm.
12 or a 12. God damn it, you motherfucker. Don't fuck me. You fuck me.
This is
22 or 24. So, 2.
20.
Or,
yeah. Two more hits. Okay.
Two good hits.
One. So Yolswag, you stab into the chest with the first hit, and with the final one, you cut into its neck about 3/4 of the way, like nearly held his neck kind of thing.
Yeah.
And as it starts to dissolve, is all, of course, absorbed into the sword. And you hear the sword whisper to you again. And it's just one word. And that is Doomslayer.
Oh boy. Okay.
Yeah.
I like the sound of that.
Now, here's what that means.
Okay.
Going forward, after you have acquired this crazy-ass dream, and this will be the first of many, I'm sure, Yolswag has spoken to you and has taught you a little bit of its ability. So
right.
Now, when you call out to Yolswag, the flame will be white and will... ignore any fire resistance or immunity.
Oh, fuck yes!
Fuck you, red dragons!
Fuck yes!
So, it has essentially shifted from regular fire to, like, hellfire.
Alright.
Nice.
I like the sound of this.
Yeah. Also, you are now, although Imsh wouldn't care necessarily about this particular fact, but you are becoming more aware that Yolswag is becoming more aware.
Okay.
So you don't know yet what that will mean down the road.
You chat me up for now, though.
It's like his imaginary friend.
Yeah, what's up, buddy? All right.
What's up, buddy?
think. So, all this came about whenever you just randomly decided to give a guard a flaming sword.
It was a half dragon. also, right before, or like right after you hear the word Doomslayer, sort of the scene goes black, and then you see a row of items. There's six total items. There's five shown, and there's one.
Dude, Von Richten's tower was a great idea.
For where the sword goes, right? So you see a dagger. I would write this down. This is important.
Okay.
you see a dagger, a maul, a longbow, a scimitar. I like that idea. Scimitar. How many is that?
That's four.
Yeah.
Four. Okay, so one more. And we'll say the last one is, you've kind of seen them.
Axe?
No. You've kind of seen them when you went to see the Tinkerer. It is a, it's a gun of some kind. It's a large gun.
Okay. All right.
So, and they all actually look to be about the same, they look like they're made of the same material, and that,
same person made them.
That they're, yeah, essentially. They look very, almost Daedric-like.
Okay.
As a matter of fact, when you wake up, because your old swag just looked like a regular sword before. But now it looks like a Daedric sword. A Daedric greatsword. Like from the Elder Scrolls series. Kind of like, almost like lava or obsidian kind of stuff.
Ooh.
You're beginning to awaken the sword.
Ooh.
So, yeah.
Ooh.
All right.
Wolf's impressed.
Ooh.
All right. I'm just like, what the fuck happened? What was that? I need to stop with this pause. Stop eating the pause.
Do Von Richten Towers, man.
Von Richten Towers.
They really.
That's it. That's it. And unlock the key. Unlock your swag.
Nagri has a dream with where he interacts with the Bail Lord, but we'll get to that some future time. Everyone else is pretty restful. Despite the crazy dream, which it would actually probably be really good dream for you because you got to kill some shit.
Yeah.
you wake up energized.
Everyone wakes up fully restored health wise. You get our spell, all that jazz. Full rest. Although you were up late, so you probably get up around, let's say, probably around 1 o'clock in the morning.
That sounds about right.
The afternoon.
Afternoon. Sorry, it's late. And so now you have options at this point.
So, I mean, the first thing I'm going to do is go buy some more arrows, because I shot a bunch of fucking arrows yesterday.
Yeah.
Arrows and crossbow bolts.
Do I have any health potions, or can I get any?
There's not really a shop in this town that would sell that sort of thing. But you could... Give me a wait, are you proficient in any kind of like brewery type shit? Or alchemy?
Not as the wolf type
one. Okay.
That's the mutagen.
Mutagen is right.
If you give me some, if it's houses, blah blah blah, I'm not worried about that. Unless you want to. The
Order of the Mutant.
Watch your house. Okay. That's pretty good. I think that'll come into play in my...
I am going to check if there's like a town notice board for any bounties that are outstanding right now as well.
Okay. Fair enough. So you actually would head then to what they call the town square. The town square.
Actually, I'm going to stay back and ask the innkeeper when I wake up about
the... It's N8, for those of you watching on the camera there. It's southeast of the inn. It's like almost directly east of Blinsky's toy shop.
Creepy fucking shop.
Yeah.
N8?
N8. Yeah, right there. Okay, so in the town square, the shops and homes that enclose the town square are decorated with limp, tattered garlands and painted wooden boxes filled with tiny dead flowers. At the north end of the square stands a row of stocks, locked in which are several men, women, and children wearing crude plaster donkey heads.
What the fuck is this town?
In the center of the square, peasants in patchwork clothes eye you suspiciously as they use cups and vases to draw water from a crumbling stone fountain. Standing tall at the center of the fountain is a gray statue of an impressive man facing west. All around the square are posted proclamations. Come one, come all, to the greatest celebration of the year, the Wolf's Head Jamboree. Attendants and children required. Pikes will be provided.
Creepy.
Pikes will be provided. All will be well. Signed, the Baron.
I want to eat a little nibble of dream pie. Just a little bit of dream pie. Just
take the edge off?
Yeah. And I feel like...
Okay. Give me a...
I feel like I'm proficient because I'm an alcoholic. And
give me a constitution saving throw.
All right. I'm not good at that at all.
Nice.
It's 18.
Okay, so... you feel the euphoria spread. And you fight off enough of it that you're not catatonic after eating it.
Okay.
So, you just feel really happy.
And I run off and find a donkey head, and I follow those guys around.
They're in the stocks. They're like...
Yeah, they're prisoners with donkey heads on.
Yeah. One thing that you notice is that the proclamation
of said jamboree... I kind of want to go take the donkey head off and run around with the donkey head off.
My God.
Okay, one second.
That sounds like a good time.
Okay, so the proclamations are out of date, which means, of course, that the Wolf's Head jamboree has already occurred.
That's a good thing.
As you're in there,
sounds like
you see
like weed eating, which is like
a this will be interesting. Eli.
Yes.
How are we on time?
We're actually pretty close.
Okay. Down, or rather, from a different street, because you guys are kind of milling about the town square. Entering into the town square are three individuals. Two of them are just in sort of standard town guard.
Guards. Two guards, though.
Huh?
Two guards.
And a death elf.
Another death elf.
A what?
The dark
my,
elf.
My
a
version.
Drow.
My version
yeah.
of the dark elves, yeah.
Okay.
Eisenschmidt, let me see your character sheet real quick.
Never a good idea.
No, that's fine. I tried to check on this as soon as we got here. I was not too sure about it.
I forget what his name is.
I might have wrote it in here, because I was not very happy that happened.
Did you give him a name in this? Yes. Yes. Nairitar.
Yeah, where are you at, Nairitar?
Which I may actually just shorten because it sounds too much like Naruto.
I like Nair.
To Raitar.
No, Nyer. I call him Nyer.
Nyer?
Yeah.
Okay.
I call him Nyer.
Works for me. Nyer. Spelled like near.
Yeah.
Cool. Nyer. Okay. Here is what that... here's how that goes down. He, the Death Elf guy, who is actually a pretty big guy for an elf. Like, he is a, he's clearly a fighter of some kind. He wields a, we'll say that he wields a greatsword. And he's in some very nice looking armor and stuff. And he gives the guards, because most of you can kind of hear this, he gives the guard commands to take down the decorations and everything. And they kind of start milling about. And then, as he's looking around the town square,
he sees us.
He sees you all. And you're not disguised in any way.
But I am going after the donkey head things immediately.
Okay.
After I ate the...
Give me a...
So I went to your fork mode, thought that was a cool thing.
No, I just want to give you a donkey head. Serendipity. Okay. So, Eisenschmidt, after having some dream pot, moves
to one of the prisoners.
To one of the prisoners, takes off the donkey head and puts it on his own. And is kind of having a good time. You can't really see through it at all.
Half
I just imagine you running around and
at all. How much can I see through it though? Like there's got to be some sort of hole.
It is maybe. Plaster. Let's see.
Oh god damn it! Stupid.
With plaster. Trick. You could have a little hole for eyes or nose.
It is plaster.
Because you have to be able to breathe out of it.
Yeah,
too,
we'll say so. That there are some holes, but it's very very limited visually.
Okay.
And. He is going, the Death Elf, who none of you know, except for him, is going to see you do that, not see your face yet, because you're kind of facing away from him, and kind of call out to you. You there. And he does not have the Barovian accent at all.
Yeah.
Why are you messing with the donkey heads?
Looked like a great idea at the time.
These people are under arrest for malicious unhappiness.
What?
Yeah. Which means spreading negative opinions about the upcoming festival. That's what it says right there.
Yeah. What?
Malicious unhappiness.
What could ever be wrong with this festival? It seems amazing.
I'm gonna quietly stow my puppet into my bag.
Yeah.
Okay. He pauses. Remove the donkey head.
Now, when he says that, I want to quickly try to catch my bearings and see if I can, like, get a good look at who I'm,
okay.
Who is speaking to me.
Give me a perception check with disadvantage.
Fourteen.
Yeah. You can... It's really hard, because it's just like little tiny holes.
Yeah.
The only thing that you can really tell immediately is that it's another Death Elf.
Okay.
Like, he has some pretty gnarly scars on his face. That you've also noticed because they very clearly stick out, like pink lines across the, you know, alabaster, like white skin. And he draws his greatsword. Remove. No accent, sorry. I'm in that mood right now.
That's alright.
Remove. Put the donkey head back. Nobody has to get hurt.
Okay. So. I'm going to take off the donkey head. But while I do it, using sleight of hand, I'm going to put on my hat of disguise and hopefully just look like a local somewhere, so
okay,
I can kind of assess the situation a little more. Because seeing a death elf here where I literally tried to find
markings... Do you really want to be a local, though? Locals kind of get fucked a lot here.
That's fine, yeah.
Well, you want something a little more exotic, but not as exotic as the death elf.
I
want
to look like the bear over there. Yeah, there's two bears floating
Give
around.
Give me a...
Where's the herd
deception?
Of bears?
No, this is going to be sleight of hand. And it's going to be disadvantage because...
You're in full view.
You have to take the full thing off and then put the mat, like the hat of disguise on to use it. So there's going to be a split second.
Okay.
So.
And I'm going to actually disadvantage 22.
He had a 19 and a 15.
God damn.
That's good. I, however, did roll high on my perception check for...
No, I canceled it.
For Nair.
Hold the fuck on.
And, of course, I would imagine at this point that everyone else is kind of, like, notices this exchange.
Yeah.
I'm trying to make it look like I don't notice. I'm just going to keep purchasing my things.
And he...
Actually, I'm going to roll stealth just for that reason.
His,
20. Actually, no, it's 23.
His surprise, 22. Like, those of you that are actually watching it, notice that his look of surprise is very, very evident.
Yeah.
And it changes from surprise to, like, blind rage almost immediately.
Yep, getting in a doorway and pulling out my crossbow.
After that. And he's going to reach down, and he has a whistle. It's like a... It's really strange. It's like made of some kind of black metal substance, and he blows on the whistle.
No, I'm shooting it out of his hand before he gets it to his mouth.
All right. give me... First of all, it's going to be disadvantage. That's a really tight shot.
Get that out there.
I'm feeling lucky. I should not have felt lucky. 14.
No. That's not going to be enough. Hit a little tiny whistle.
Damn. Do I at least hit his hand?
And he... No.
Maybe he doesn't blow the whistle.
He... he actually... The arrow shooting by doesn't even face him. He blows on the whistle, and no sound seems to come out.
Can we use the summon in the party?
Most of you. You have keen hearing, right?
If I'm wolfy.
Okay. You have keen hearing. Is it Raven? Is that right?
Nope.
No, okay.
Ravens actually can't hear for shit.
Fair enough. So, no...
He might.
You don't hear any...
I'm just a bear.
That said, out of a lot of the houses around the town square, guards start rushing into the town square.
Huh.
And I mean, a lot of guards.
I believe it's the time to
Fuck off.
Yo, swag out and yell yo, swag.
Eisenschmidt. Have I ever seen this guy?
No, no. What are you guys talking about?
He is new, relatively new. You do know that he is a henchman of the Baron.
So I would know who he is.
Yeah, you might know who he is.
I used to work for the Baron.
Yeah, yeah.
Unknowingly, but I did.
Nier. Orlidtep?
Orlyup.
Your long lost brother.
Fuck.
Who you left behind to die to escape the Underdark because you weren't really feeling it.
Best excuse ever.
I really wasn't.
I'm going on vacation.
It was not fun. Drinking, playing games.
He almost died.
Dream pies.
Of course, after all the guards are showing up, and it's a lot. It's a lot of guards. Which is not to
say... I'm still stealthed.
Right, I gotcha. Which is not to say necessarily that...
Are they all human guards?
They are all human guards, yeah.
Okay.
They're locals.
They are local guards. There's a bunch of them, right? Yeah. So, like... This is not to say that you couldn't wipe the floor with most of them, even though there's a shit ton of them, but that would be not a very good act, per se.
Nair just said Eisenschmidt, that's what he said.
Yeah.
And
which all of you heard.
Yeah.
I'm going to take off my disguise, because I'm wearing the disguise he saw, I guess, like a flicker going on. And I'm gonna say,
"Hey, bro.
Sup, bro?
You mad, bro?
No, I'm gonna say, looks like you're a little lost too.
Well. Oh, okay. Question. It's two. It's almost three. You guys want to end it? This is a great place to end it. Nice cliffhanger.
Yeah, I like cliffhangers.
Okay. Yeah."
Sure.
All right.
Plus I gotta be back here at 6 o'clock.
But bro. that's how I'm gonna say it looks. Looks like you're a little lost too, bro.
I like it. That is where we will end this session. This is gonna be fun.
Oh man.
We're completing one of Eisenschmidt's backstory things.
Please don't kill me.
We'll see you guys in a couple weeks, I guess. And I don't know if we're doing the evil campaign or what, but we'll
doing something for the 4th of July.
We'll figure it out. Oh, shit, 4th of July. No.
We'll figure that out.
I'll be here.
No,
I will be here that Friday.
Anyway.
4th of July is the Friday after.
Later.
Friday. Sunday. 4th of July.